Good afternoon, everyone. Please feel yourself welcomed here. For those who have joined in new, I am Anuja, and I do a lot of types of paintings, and I have a very diversified interest. So there are a lot of folk arts, abstract art, and other things that we are doing. So today is our fifth day of our Warli workshop, and we have done, so far we have done all the borders. We have done human figures, plants, animals, and the houses. And the fourth day we did the tarpa. Tarpa is the dance form. Now today we are going to do a painting which is the very traditional form of the Warli people, and they call it Dev Chowk or the Lagna Chowk. These chowks were painted in the times where they initially started when there was a wedding. In the wedding house, the married ladies, they were known as Savasini. They used to paint the walls of the house. It was considered auspicious, and a lot of merrymaking comes along with it. So there is a Dev Chowk. And today we are going to do the Lagna Chowk. Lagna Chowk, and I have taken a very big paper so that you do not mess on to anything. I was just making a border here. This is a big one, so I might leave few portions for you to continue and repeat the same. The painting of it is the Lagna Chowk. Now, what pens I'm using, I will tell you the material that is required. I have taken red paper, and this is no special red paper. It is just the chart paper. So I have cut it into pieces. I'll just show it to you. This is a chart paper, and you cut it to your desired size. And I have sticked it to my cutting board. So my this cutting board, paper cutting board, I have stick it here so that it doesn't roll back. So this is the paper, and what pens do we use? So if you do not panic that you do not have a red color paper, you do not have any, you can pick any paper and do your work. So even if you have a white paper, you can draw it on the white paper using your black pen. I have done in other forms also. And this is the Dev Chowk. Now, since those people of those times, the Warli people, they used to pray a lot, they used to worship a lot, but they never used to worship a deity. They used to worship only Falghat Devi, and Falghat Devi was the deity they used to praise, and she was the symbol of fertility. Fertility, if I mean, it is not only the childbirth, it is the fertile land, fertility in cattle, and all the forces should be in harmony. And that is when the fertility will flow. So they used to pray this, and they used to pray the powers or the forces of nature, the sun, moon, the wind god, rain god, all those. And as they started agriculture, they initially started with hunting and gathering. They were hunters and gatherers. And after that, with a little bit of change, they started shifting agriculture. So when we see the pictures, we see that there are a lot of movement. There's a lot of agriculture activities. The settings are in small community groups. And there's a lot of mobility. People carrying things, going. It is not very static. So that is their lifestyle. And today we are going to do the Lagna Chowk. The Lagna word is from the marriage. We call, in Hindi also we call Lagna as Shadi, marriage. So in marriage, this Dev Chowk is made at all the auspicious occasion, be it a childbirth or a new house or anything, harvest or any good sign, they will do the worship of this Falghat Devi, which is the Dev Chowk. Now, when they make the Lagna Chowk, they also, how will they leave the Dev? They will also pray the Falghat Devi. So this is a bigger paper that I have taken. It is an A3 size that I cut. And now here I will be placing the same Dev chalk. So what pencils and pen I will be using, I'll show you. If you do not have red paper, please use your white and black. So just to sketch on the colored paper, if we need to do it with any color, this is my pencil. This is my white pencil. It is from Apsara. So if you can see it, it's Apsara pencil and it is white in color and you get it for 5 rupees. If you do not have big paper of A3 size, you can use 2-3 papers so that you don't miss the elements. You draw it, and when you have a bigger paper, you will do the drawing accordingly. Now we also get very bold markers like this. These are the paint markers. I have art line paint marker. So if you are painting bold tip, see, this has a bold tip. I will work with this also and show you how it works. It is thicker line. So here, this is thick line. It works as paint. Once it dries, you cannot wipe it off, right? And then we have, for thin detailings, we have jelly roll or the uniball sakura, a uniball signal. I will give the description in of the links of it in the description box. Now I will place my camera overhead so that you get a good glance of what work we are doing. Any questions so far, please ask me. You can do it on a yellow paper. Ideally, these pictures were done on either brown base or the red base. Red base is that the wall was painted with the soil, which was red in color, or with the cow dung, or with the cow dung, which was brown in color. So either brown or red were the ideal base colors. If you have an A4 size, you can do it. How do we, if you have to sketch on a white paper, you can always do it with pencil. Okay. No, Dev chalk and the Lagna chalk are slightly different. Dev chalk, we only make the Devi, that is the Phalgar Devi. And in Lagna chalk, we'll have the marriage procession also. We will do that. And the symbols where marriages are taking place. So there will be, when we did the third day, when we did the mandap of that on that day, then we did a shed where the marriage was taking place. If you have missed that, you do view the third day where you will get the mandap, how to make it. We'll do it today as well. So here, I was making this border. You can also choose from any other border that we discussed in our day one class. Now, I will show you the working with the checking of the pens here so that you get the idea of how they work. So when I'm picking this part paint marker, this is quite thick. So this tip is retractable. So you need to pump a little. You need to push and then some paint will come on that and then you can draw with this. So it is not very nicely covered, so I'll just pump it 2 times and then I'll get the paint. And this is how you can just speed up your work with the bold marker. If in case you do not have this marker, the other option is that how this pencil works, I'll show you this pencil so you will have the idea of how the things come on paper. So I'll just show you one with the pencil. It comes equally good and it's very economical. It comes for 5 rupees and this can be given to kids as well. So this, there is not much of a difference. Whereas if you see, you will see that this pointed tip actually gives a very sharp curves, points, right? So this is the pencil work. So this is, I'm kind of reviewing all the tools. So this is this pencil and I showed you with this art line marker pen. Now the next thing that I'll show you is the uniball signal. So here I'm doing it with the next one. This is for thinner details. So if you do it with this, you will take a lot of time
filling up the thing. And then because it's very thin line, it's a 0.5 pen. So this will not work. It can only work with for small details. So if I'm just making the circles, it will work fine. Right? So for the smaller details, you can use this. You can use white paper and you can use black pen also. The next one is the jelly roll that I use sometimes. Yeah. If you do not feel, you do not have this paint marker, fine. If you do not have this pencil, okay, leave it. If you have these pens, fine. If you do not have these pens also, what is the option? Then you will take the acrylic paint. How to use your acrylic paint on this? You'll just take a brush. You can also use your watercolors or your poster colors. I will show you that also. So here, just taking the white. Yes, Suresh Murthy, you can use white paper. So here I'm just taking little water and I am doing the drawing. So if you are not very confident how to go about with the paint in the one go, then you can always draw it with pencil. Since it is with white, grab a white pencil. And this gives a very good coverage. Okay, so these are the tools I'm just checking in front of you, showing you, so that you do not get confused as what should you buy. Now, if you do not have acrylic paints, many of the kids who are working with me do not have acrylic paints. Fine. You have some watercolors like these. So here I'm just taking the white. With this also, the coverage comes really good. So just take some water because these cakes are really hard. They need to just soften a little. Generally, we do not use pencil colors in this. But yeah, if you have to draw, you can draw it with white pencil. So here I'm taking this white and you will see that not much of a difference when I'm drawing it with the poster color also. But you do not have to use it too watery. You have to make it a like a thick paste. You have to take good amount of poster color and then do it. So these, from here I started, I showed you everything and not much of a difference. So you can have your own choice and do it, whether pencil, whether pen, or whether the poster color or anything. But whenever you are trying to do a fresh painting, always do a testing on the wrong side of the paper. And then you can check. So right now I'm going to do the Dev Chowk. I'm just leaving this border because this border can be completed in the same manner. So taking the picture in the center of the picture, I have drawn the Dev Chowk. So just a little bit of line. Chowk means that it will be in a square. Chowk comes from the word chowk. Chowk is like a square, chowkor. That's the shape. Thank you, Purva. Thank you. Thank you. It took me a while reading your comment. Thank you. So here, like this. So we'll just make a chowk. Chowk is from a chowkor, that is a four sides, four angles, a square. Okay. Even if you are using an A4 size, plan yourself and make it like hook. Okay, here I am using A4 size paper. I am showing you A4 size paper just to get for you to get the idea. So for those who are using a smaller paper, please, here we will be making the border. I'll show it to you with pen. So make the border here. I'm just doing it very rough just to give you the idea. All the corners, border. Then the chowk will find the center. So this is the chowk and it finds the center. We have, because The goddess is considered to be a little superior, of course, and so a bigger and a better place is given, showing the high peak. It is a pedestal. It is decorated with the corners and multiple borders. Today, my video will also get uploaded for Dev Chowk. So then you can understand better on Dev Chowk. It is just like this. We have the square and then you make a couple of borders. Asmita, if you have missed the pen review, you can revisit the recording of this. Right now, you can just pick any pen and practice with us. So this is the square. And you can do different kind of. I will switch to A4. I will switch to A4 wherein I will show you different things. So here. So I'm using it with my pencil. Just make a couple of double borders. You can use black sketch pen, Swara. That's okay. Right? And then we'll give it a higher pedestal like this, as I showed it to you in the white paper. Now, it totally depends how big you want to make it. You can just layer one border or two border or whatever. Here, there are two options. I will show you. This one is a little more decorated, whereas the other one, which I made, had a corner like this. So the corner can be just two circles, and then these lines and circles symbolizes flowers. So here what I have done is I have made a swirl. So just make a small square. The easy way I'm telling, just make small squares. Then from this one, make a outward circle. Here make an outward circle. Here also make an outward circle. Like this. Yes, you can take pencils if you're practicing. Yes, Tarpa dance is there. It is uploaded on the channel. You can watch it. It was, it's done in a very elaborate way. So here, how I draw it like this. But if you're not comfortable in one go, you can just make a square and then make the similar endings for all the three corners like this. No worries if you have any other pen or any other color paper, it is okay. The main thing is that you have to learn what is the concept behind and how it is made. So here, now how do we symbolize that there is a flower? I'm just doing the chalk first. So the triangles. Like this. Hello, hi. Just filling up with circles. Warli people were very, very simple people because they were from the tribe. So Adivasi, they had limited resources and limited privileges. They had a very hard life. So we see the simplicity in their drawings also. Hi, Nakshatra. So here we can plant a small tree kind of here, like this. Now, we have done our day three with all sorts of plants and trees. We will do few of them here as well. Those who have missed any of the session, it will be easier for you to understand the concept and the formation of things if you view those videos as well. It's a 5-day course, and you can do it. So just making few like this, very simple. So this is my wave chalk, and here when we are doing it in a Lagna chalk, because it is a marriage, we will just make a small kalash over here. They do make the kalash. They make a pot full of grains. They put the leaves and coconut. So this is there. This is there. And we decorate it with small lines and dots. So after this, if you check the description box of the video, you will get all the links of purchasing all sorts of pens and papers and pencil. You will get it. That like flower, which like flower? This flower. If this flower, I will suggest, I'll just show you here. Here, the flower that we made, we just made a square over here. And then just make small petals like thing. Okay. This is the thing. For any other doubts, you can just check. I will show it to you separately. And whatever was used, you can also do it like this. I will show you the next one. You can also do it like this. You will see both of them. This is a variation because I already covered this in my tutorial. You will see that I will share the link of my video of Dev Chow, which is done very explicitly. Okay. I'm drawing it on a chart paper. It's a red chart paper. I have cut it to a size of A3. Now, Devi is just the same as we do the human. So please make this. Hands spread out, raised up like this. And there is a crown that is kept on the head. So this. For bigger portions, I'm taking my pen and I'm just coloring that. And the feet. Very angular. There is no soft movement. They are very angular. Then the fingers. So this. Oh, very simple. This is a symbolic picture of the Devi. Now with this, inside this Dev Chalk, there are elements as the sun and the moon. So make it very simple. Sun and the moon. Sun rays are shown in dotted lines moving outwards. And this is the Dev Chalk. Right. Now, because it is a Lagna Chalk, Lagna Chalk, Lagna means marriage. Marriage, we have to show the marriage. I will show you. There is a bride and the groom. So, it's not important which place you want to place your bride and the groom, but this picture shows a lot on the festivities and celebrations. So, here I'm making a place where marriage is taking place. So, this is... Sorry about that. It's gone. I'll have to sharpen it again. So here, this is a shed kind of a tree.
of a thing like a mandap.
So here, and the mandap is made up of sticks. So here are the sticks. It's okay if you're doing it on A4 size. You can make things smaller because anyway you won't be using paint. You can use your gel pen or any other pen. So it's okay. Just make things smaller. That is okay. Now here there is some valance. Valance are the garlands that are there. So you just do this. And this dots in this picture in Warli symbolizes flowers. So we are just doing dots on this. We are not making flowers like we make in Madhubani or any other art. So do not make it very detailed, just dots. And in the corner, here leaves. The plantain leaves or the banana leaves, just make those leaves. Now here on top, we will cover it with the haystack. Little bit of hay. So just make broken lines. You don't have to be very precise or geometrically same length lines. Just cover it with the broken lines. Here, now here again we will just make few bunches of leaves or small these for decorations, because the decorations that was done was only from the flowers and the plant's leaves. You can make small leaves onto this. So all the happy things we can form over here. So here, this is the mandap that is ready. Now here you can put the garlands going down. It is up to you how elaborate and how beautiful you want it to be. Okay. Now here I'm making the center, and I'm here making the pot. Just make the kalash. Here is one figure, consider it as a bride, and here is one, consider it as a groom. So a boy and a girl. How will we differentiate between both of them? I will show you in the detailing that we will do. The foot, and they are standing on a wood base. Okay, now the lady and the man both are holding the garland. So how do we show the garland? We'll just shape it with dots. Like this. So these are the garlands. Thank you. Thank you. If you're liking it, do give me a thumbs up. I see 42 likes right now and 161 people attending. So if you're liking it, just give me a like so that I know that whether you all are enjoying it, whether you are understanding it. Thank you. Yes, I can see. Okay, thanks Manju. Thank you everyone. Thank you. I'm getting a lot of smileys and thumbs ups in the chat box. Thanks. Thanks. So here, now how do we make it a lady? We are just making the head. And it will be the same as the boy. But here, since it is a marriage, they do adorn themselves. So for the lady, we are just adding a cloth piece here, just like her dress. And we will not color it flat. We will just make it lined to show that it is a fabric and it is not a solid part, right? Whereas we will just color the figures block with white. So this white that I'm using as a pencil was actually used, the rice paste was used, and rice was grinded into powdered form, mixed with water and plant gum that acted as a binder. Now, after this boy and the girl, we do a sehra for this groom. So the sehra is pointed hat and some flowers sticking out. So we're just making a small sehra for him. Sehra in Hindu marriages, I don't know about in Hindu marriages also we see sehra, but we've also seen it in the tribal marriages. And the girl, this is the bun and flowers on the head. So please catch up till here. Make these two figures. There is a small detailing that makes them different as the bride and the groom. I hope you can. You are good with us here. Now we will be making on the other side. Since it's a happy thing, we have done tarpa dance in our fourth day session, and this is the place where we will be doing the tarpa dance. No, Falgar Devi also has two hands, and this is the hand. This is just one hand and two hand and one leg and the second leg. Okay. So if it is not very clear here, I'll show it to you here. See, there's only two hands and two legs. So not four hands. I will show it, the Devis here also and here also if you want to see. Okay. So this is the Devi. Very simple. It's a triangular figure. That's it. Okay. Now on this side, on the other side, so to get check the proportions, you can check it. So this is my page over here. This is the page. And I've made one side, I've made this. And the other side is blank here. And now I'm going to do the tarpa dance, which we did at length yesterday. But now here you can do the tarpa dance or a few people dancing. Depends on your wish. So from yesterday's day before yesterday's class, our fourth class, you can pick up the musicians and the dance, and you can do it here. So this place I'm leaving it for now. If we have time, we will do the tarpa here again. Now down I'm going to do a barat. Barat is a procession that shows that the doli and the horse and taking the groom, everything. So from the left side, from here I'm starting. So just giving some space for my border so that I know where I have to start. Just roughly. So here, I know where I have to place it. Now here, just making the similar figures, triangle figures. Like this. Now the people are moving in a procession. So this is the hand of one, and he is holding a banner or anything showing that It's covered with flowers and leaves. So generally these banners or these kind of things are in the beginning of the procession and in the end of the procession. No worry, Prabha, if you do not have any place, you already know when you have a bigger paper, you can place your tarpa there. Just write down that that's this place is for tarpa. Okay, so this. Now, these all the procession here, I am making a doli. A doli is a carriage, kind of a carriage which carries the bride. So one big line. And the carriage I will make. Like this. You have to hang it here. So you can make a small change in your doli, whichever way you want it to be. Slight variation is okay. Now here, how do we make the bride sitting and the people carrying this? So just give it a little thickness and two people this side. They are moving this side and therefore the foot is all the foot will go in one direction because the procession is leading in one direction. We cannot have half of them going back. So here, this is the, these are the two people who are holding this carriage. And how do we make the ladies sitting? So those who have not viewed, I'm again repeating, the confusion will be very less if in case you view the video of the day two where we are doing the formation of people sitting and standing. So this is the lady. Sitting. So we see that it is bent. Thank you, Ma. Thank you. So just filling it up. How will we do it? Here, we will just again put the same valance and flowers like we did it in the mandap. Again, put the dots and that will show that these are flowers. You can elaborately design it and the cloth also. You can do the cloth on both the sides and bun and beautiful hair design. So I'm taking a small pen to do the dots on the bun, which will show that this is a nice hairstyle. So she is sitting inside. You can also make the cloth here as curtain. It totally depends how much you want to do. And here, just dots. But remember that no curvy designs, only dots and lines. Very simple design. Like this. So with the pen, you will see that you can do the detailing in smaller portions. And you can continue doing your design. Now, moving on to the groom or the boy. I'll just fill this portion with flat coloring so that it looks better. like this. Thank you. I love everybody. I'm loving everyone. You're showing me good numbers. You're doing your work. So this is a marriage procession now. Now, how about to make a groom? So we will make the animal, and that's the horse. For horse, we are doing a little thinner, not very bigger triangles, longer kind of triangles like this. Like this. We will fill it up with white. Then a small curve to show the neck. Thank you, Suresh. Thank you. Oh, okay. Thank you. When I start getting all the likes, I feel even more joyous. So this is a small triangle that symbolizes the face of the horse. And the mane. How do we show the mane? Now, what is the mane? Mane is the hair that grow on the neck. So with the small pen, I'm doing it so that I get very fine lines here. And the ear. Like this. So I got this. Now for the tail, I will be doing this with lots of lines over here. So nice bushy tail. You don't have to be very symmetrical. Even if your lines are joining, that's okay, because it is not supposed to be very proportionate, right? Now how the horse is trotting. So one leg will be straight. Now when we make the hooves, we make semicircles and then put a base on it like this. So these are the hooves. Like for men, we make those small feet. For the animals, we make hooves, and two of them are straight. Like this. Looks that it is just standing, not moving. But now we will just do it like this. Just one folded leg, again, hoof there. Leg folded, hoof there. And this shows the movement of the horse. Thank you, Swara. Sure. Catch up till here. I'm still waiting. Any other questions that if you have, you can. Real fear of marriage, okay. Thank you, yes. Warli art is very, very, we have very a lot of limitations, but still these simple lines and patterns never fail to give the message. So the art, what I feel is, no matter how primitive, how modern, or how raw or very fine or skilled, whatever type of art it is, it should just convey the message. And it's just a form of expression. And yes, if we come across the expression, then we think that we were successful in drawing it. Thank you, Neetu. Yes, those who wish to get the certificates can give me the message on my Facebook page. You can message me directly and I'll let you know the details on the certification of the course. Okay, so now here I will start. Probably I gave you. There are two bride and two grooms? No. This is only one marriage. One chowk is made for one marriage, Lagna marriage. This is when the marriage is taking place. And now this is when she is going. So it is just one picture showing different phases of marriage. It's not two weddings happening. Now here on the horse comes the groom. So the groom is again here in triangles. We'll just make two triangles, again the head, now the same triangular hat, and then the flowers, strings, the Sahara that is. And he is followed by his companion. And how do we make his foot go straight and then here like this? This is the man sitting on the... Now, he will be holding the reins of this. This is his hand. Here will be another one. He's holding a big leaf. A big leaf to cover the groom. So this. Thank you, Vimla. Thank you. You please contact to me those who are willing for the certificates. Please write me a message and then I'll give you the details on that. So here, this is our detail for this groom. Now, what else will be there in the procession? There will be people. Now I'm using my pen, so you will get the idea of how the pencil was working and how the pen. The pen will be a little more crisp. So if you have thinner places to work on. So this here, we will take few musicians. So this and here, we'll show a little movement with the feet moving like this. So one a little forward. One more thing I forgot is the stand of the this of the dolly. Once it is placed down, it has a stand. So you can make simple design and dots pattern. You can also do a little more elaborate decoration on this. I'll show you. This is a very commonly used decoration which symbolizes that it is a flower. So how do we do this? Now, accessorizing thing is just to our own heart's content. How much ever you want to decorate, you may decorate. So, but I'll just show you how it will look, because how can the bride be not decorated and the groom decorated so well? So here, I just decorated this a little more. Now, this in the procession, this is there. People dancing, cymbals, or any other, whatever musical instruments you want to put in your procession, you can. I will make few. So, tarpa is a very important, as I told, tarpa. This is not a tarpa. Tarpa is done in a manner. It is made up of vegetable. Yesterday also we had a talk. Day before yesterday also we had a talk on tarpa. Tarpa is very pure and very important instrument for them. And it is made of the bottle gourd. When it is ripe, they scoop off the things, the pulp and the seeds, just like we make jack-o'-lanterns in Halloween. And then this hard shell is placed, and then these leaves are placed, and this is the tarpa. This is attached with a string, and it is beautifully decorated with the feathers of peacock. So this is a tarpa, very beautifully done, and this is a tarpa player. So tarpa is a very for them it is not just a musical instrument. They believe that it's the God's voice. That kind of importance they give to tarpa. Now here I'll just fill up the ma'am, you did not fill the I have to still fill. I'm just ready to fill everybody. Yeah. I have to fill. I have to just switch the pen for that. So all the figures will be solid white. Only hands and legs will be thin lines, whereas the body has to be like this. Okay. Yeah. You can use pen, or you can use color pencil, or you can use the paint or the poster color, anything. Now, here, one more which is holding the first banner, like the one which we made. In the end, so here, and again with the same flower, decorating it. I will show you the figure on the horse in the rough page. I will show it to you. I'll do the repeat of it. You don't have any place. Okay. Those who do not have any place for the big procession, they can just, because these figures we have already done so far as musicians and banner holder and all. The only very important thing is the bride sitting in this palki and the groom on the horse. So these two things, if you learn, then when you have a bigger thing to do the procession, you will be able to do it. So I will just give you a rough a repeat of this picture here. Big, I will show you how to do it. So for those who missed. So generally we do the triangles like this, right? But we are not doing it like this. We are doing it in a little extended way. So a longer body. So here, this way, this way. So quite stretched. Like this. Then a curve, a triangle, ears, and the mane. So mane is just the thin hair on the horse's neck. You will make the horse trotting, straight leg with hoof, straight leg with hoof, and one folded with the hoof. So here, this is the one folded with the hoof. So this shows that it is moving. And then, yeah, I'll show you the bride as well. This is the tail. Now, how to make the people sit? Put cross here and put one more cross here. Now, the leg will move down. Both the legs are showing down. The head. For them, so they are so far similar, right? There's no change. Now here, two hands holding one big stick, and on top of that there is a leaf, a big leaf to give the shade, or probably more importance to the groom. Thank you, Deepa. So here, this is the leaf. Now, how to make the groom, as we did there in the mandap? This is his hat, and these are the strings with flowers. That is a special hat. That is what is keeping him separate from the crowd. Now, his hands, you can have both of them straight, and he is holding the reins of the horse, and they both are moving. The hooves also, you can just color it flat. So this is our horse, the groom. Now, those who want me to repeat the bride sitting posture, I'll tell you, I'm not doing the full palki. Palki is very simple. So when we do the sitting posture, we do it like this, right? So one triangle here, the other triangle here. Fill it up. You can have both the legs like this. You can have hands like this on the shoulder, on the knee, like this. You can have a little movement in her sitting like this. How do we differentiate? We have made the bun, the beautiful accessory on her hair. So this is showing that she is all dressed up, all hair decked up. Now we will add the fabric that we made in the mandap also. So this is the girl, and if you have to enclose her into a palki, you will be just doing it like so. So this is the zoomed out picture of how it is. Now here, if you have to, here I showed you, you can also do it in a valance form like this. If you want to make it like a flower hanging from top, this also looks very beautiful. You can do this as well. So these are flower bunches hanging down, because the palki will also be decorated, right? If you want to do the valance, you will just put the garlands. If you want to do, you will just do it like this. So you can have your own variations, whichever way you want it to be. Here, if you want to add cloth in it, here again, leaves I'm adding, and this, you can add whatever design. So this, and again, it will get extended and the people will be holding it. So this is just one side I'm showing. And since they are moving here, like this, fine. So this is the bride and this is the groom, all zoomed out, repeated again. Fine. So this with this, our Dev Chowk is in the middle. Our marriage is happening here in this side. The full bottom from left to right, we have covered the procession that is taking place. And now, I'll just show you a little bit of this corner also, as in the musicians and the dancers. So the tarpa dance. Those who have seen it or those who have not seen it can just have a repeat of it. Now, tarpa dance can go in spiral also, at it, or it can just go in a half spiral as well. So here I will just show you, not very elaborate, just making it like this. So I'm just creating a spiral, whichever way you want it to be, in this kind of a manner, right? So just very little, like a swirl. Now, a few people showed me their work also, and I want to tell you one more thing, which is really very important. How do you make your tarpa figures symmetrical and not bent? Okay, so when we make our thank you, Smita. So when you are making your tarpa, so here you make this broken line. Fine. This is okay. Sometimes the spacing between the figures is too much. So keep that in mind. The next thing is that how to keep your figure straight. Because if your figure is like this, then it is slant and it is not right. It won't look very good. So how will it look nice? You've made these broken lines. Now you make a straight line. I'll show you here. So try it this way, it'll come perfect. So you have this flat line. Now make it like a perpendicular line in the center. Now I am making a circle for the head, and like this. Now, once you do this, your picture and cross it in the center, your picture will not move. It will not shake because you have a spine to your figure. Okay. So once you have a spine to your figure, your picture will come perfectly straight. So this is one way which you can do, because I'm just telling you this method because I know that there are many small children who are following and trying to do it, and they were saying, ma'am, it's not coming straight. So for that, so if you're not getting it right like this, then just make the bottom line and make a line like this. Then on top, just fix a ball, just like a lollipop, and then the shoulder. You will see that both the lines are equal, and then you will cross it this way. And this will give you a perfect standing figure. Fine. Now I will be doing the same thing here, which is Tarpa dance. Shah TV. Okay. I don't know what your name is, but yeah, what I was showing was a Tarpa dance figure. So Tarpa dance is a dance that is done by those tribes, and it is known as a community dance, and everybody dances together. And in the center, there is a Tarpa player, which we will draw. So the Tarpa player is the main person who starts the instrument, and then the people just join in. They might not know why the Tarpa is being played, but once it is played, everybody joins it, and it has a loose end all the time. It has a loose end for people to join in. So it is never like in a concentric circle. If it is in a concentric circle, it is not the authentic Tarpa. It might be just like a mandala or so. So, like this. So the dance can be big or small. You can have one circle or many, depending on how big the Tarpa is. Generally, it is done on marriages or any other community celebration. So this dance is also of great relevance in the Lagna job. So here, these are the basic form, and now I'm just making the head. And in the center will be the Tarpa player. Now the people will be moving their feet in one direction. Because the circle goes either clockwise or anti-clockwise. So they have to follow the same direction. So Tarpa dance was the main element that we discussed in our day 4 Warli workshop. And this workshop is of 5 days for those who have joined us new. And if in case you have missed any of the sessions, please view them and get the whole knowledge about what you are drawing. Because they might look very simple, but knowing the history and importance and the relevance, how important the things are for them, it really attaches it you to your work. So if you're making a picture, you should know why and how of the picture. So they hold the waist of each other and dance in a circle. So we're just repeating that. And the first person who is in the center will hold a very big stick, a bamboo stick. And the tarpa player plays the tarpa in the middle. So this is the picture of Dev Chowk. This is the Lagna Chowk, wherein we have the Dev Chowk also in the middle. So they have plants. Which they pray. So we just make plants and the forces of nature also. Now this is a very happy scene. And we can also make few happy things. Like you can make the sun in one corner. You can make the sun over here. The sun god. There are different ways of making sun. Here I'm making a very small one, like a swirl, and the triangles. Now you will see that Warli paintings are being done on canvas, cloth, plastic, artifacts, home decor, everywhere they use it. Because it is a very monochromic paint, it's monochromic because it is only two colors and it gives a very modern look also. So this is the sun and just doing the rays. So just the V kind of a thing to show the rays. I think in our previous session, we made a different kind of sun. So there is no set pattern that you, there is only one style you can express yourself. So this is the sun over here, and here we can make bird. How about I make a bird over here? Right, so this, just to give it a little more symmetry, I'm just doing it here. We also see the presence of peacock. I'll show you a smaller peacock, how do we make it, because mostly when there are happy scenes we see peacock dance as well. It has a very suggestive meaning that yeah, it's all happy and peacocks are dancing. So this way, and I can have a peacock over here. I'll just show it. So just one circle. I'll zoom it a little down so that you can see. Oh, Smita, don't miss me and my sessions. I will just stay connected. We have a lot many things coming up. Just stay connected. There's nothing like Mama. I'm going to miss you. We'll keep on doing this. So here it is a small S kind of a shape that we do here. Very simple. Thank you, Padmini. Thank you, Samriddhi. Yes, you can definitely. If you do not have the place for doing the whole dance, you can just do few of the musicians or few people dancing.
That is totally okay, Madhumita.
So this is the body, really very thin here, and just joining it like it is dancing. So we're just making it like this. So if you've got it till here, and here I'm just making circle and one line, circle and one line. And then here you put the dots. This shows that it is a very symbolic picture. These are not the realistic kind. So you just make the symbols. So this kind of a feather spread is the trail of the peacock, and peacock has it on his head as well. There are very big paintings on this. If it's not a small one, if it is a big one, you can do a little more on the wings and feather. So if you, for those who really want the certification on this, please contact us on my Facebook page. Message me directly and then I'll give you all the details. And then the this, just making it a body a little thicker. And then inside also we will draw. You can make a couple of them if you want, two or three. You can just fill in the places. You can do different elements here in the corner. When I see that there is some place which is vacant, I'll just put it on top so that you can see. Here, this side is the sun, but what about this side? So this side is a little vacant. Let me do some birds over here as well. Now these are the flying birds. So we do not do a lot of detail work, I'm repeating. So do not feel that, oh, I can do better than this, and we keep on doing a lot of maybe details. This has its limitation, and the simplicity of this picture is very unique. Thank you, Gauri. Thank you. Thank you, Sujit. Thank you, everyone. Thank you. So here we can do a couple of birds to fill the space. And then you can also make people like the green trees also. Then people doing their course, like whatever they are doing. Not everybody is dancing. Maybe a procession is passing by the village. And then if your paper is very big, you can actually do the more onto this. So more elements. So here, this is the picture. Any doubts that you have?
Yes. How to make Warli fire? Arush, I think we did it in our previous class when we did the human figures. People were cooking. So this is our full picture, how it looks like. Oh, the fish, I will show it to you in the separate paper. It's very simple. I'll just show you. So here, when we do this, here again, there is one thing that you can do. These triangles you need to fill. So you can just fill these triangles like this. So the chalk will get all brightened. Okay. So this is the Tarpa dance, the sun, this. Forever, for the places wherever you see that there are a lot of gaps, you can make trees also. Beautiful birds, everything that is beautiful, no hunting, nothing. We don't want to make all that in the Lagna chalk. So Lagna chalk is only the Devi finds the place in the center. And the procession, then the marriage happening, then the dance happening, all these things will be shown. Nahi, Warli painting aage bhi hoti hai, Sanjay Thakur. वार्ली पेंटिंग में बहुत सारी चीजें दिखाई जाती हैं और कोई आपके इमेजिनेशन की पे लिमिट नहीं है, आप जो भी दिखाना चाहते हैं लेकिन आप उसके स्टाइल को पकड़ के रखना है. थैंक यू आर्ना. सो कुकिंग फॉर श्वेता नाइक, फॉर कुकिंग यू हैव टू चेक आवर डे टू वेर वी डिड ऑल द figures. I hope I, with your question, I can make out that you were not a part of our second day workshop. And our second day workshop, we did a lot of things. I'll show you the papers just right in front of me. This is the third day when we did, and we did different kind of houses, animals, the marriage also happening, different kinds of birds, people, the climbing and everything. This is the cooking going on. So we do not give shade in this. There is no shading in this. We just give lines and dots. Thank you. Okay, what is the name of the goddess that... It's Palghat Devi. Palghat Devi. They only pray their own devas. It's not the other... Thank you. So here I'm going to end the session, and yes, we all will meet soon. My next session will be on mandala art. I will announce it on my Facebook page. The link, I will send it in the chat box, those who are not following. And yes, those who have not subscribed so far, please subscribe to the channel. That is the little thing that you can do for all the hard work that we are doing. So please do subscribe the channel. That is also very important for me. And yes, we'll have more workshops, and then you can connect on that. So here, those who wanted the certificates can contact me, and then I will give you the details on that. Okay. Thank you, everyone. See you soon. Bye-bye. Thank you.